Okay, hi, I'm Vasudha, and I'm going to be talking about my GSUC project this year. Cool, I don't know why it isn't going full screen. Okay, so Ruqola is a chat application for Rocketchat, and Rocketchat is a server, and Ruqola is a client. So we're just creating an interface for Rocketchat client. So that's the logo for Ruqola, and Alex made it from Kirigami. You know, it's a cutout image of a leaf that represents Ruqola there. So firstly, where did the name Ruqola came from? Anyone? For the non-Italian people here. For the non-Italian people. Okay, so anyone? Yeah. Since we're using Rocketchat, so we're building an interface for Rocketchat, and in Italy, there's a salad called Rocket Salad. And salad in Italian is called Ruqola with a C. But since we're using cute, we have Ruqola with a Q. So that's how Ruqola got its name. So a bit about Rocketchat. It's a web server, web chat server. It's developed in JavaScript. And it's built over Meteor framework. So it's like there's this Meteor layer, and then there's Rocketchat layer, and then there's this Ruqola layer. So that's how it goes. Then what makes Ruqola's backend? So by these, there are these classes. By these classes, I mean to show you the features we have in Ruqola. Okay, so there's this Ruqola class. It is the singleton class. It manages all the other classes in Ruqola. Then there's the DDPClient class. It's a generic interface to Meteor's DDP. DDP is distributed data protocol. So we send messages through DDPClient class. Then there's a message model class. There's a message object, and this class handles the message object. Message object contains the user, time of sending, and all the fields which a message should contain, normal fields. Then there's, similarly, there's a room model. Rooms are channels which you subscribe to. Basically, Wiki to Learn will use Ruqola for their own website to discuss the content fidelity, whether it's right or not, or user have any conflicting opinions. So that's why we have Ruqola for Wiki to Learn. But it's a general application, generalized and abstracted, so anyone can use it really. Then there's a Rocketchat backend class. We have subscriptions in this. Users can subscribe to channels or rooms or messages. Then there's a message queue class which handles network management. So network management is when a user is offline and he sends messages, so the messages are stored in a queue. Till he comes online, they'll be stored in a backend and will be sent automatically when the user comes online. So that's what the message queue class does. Then we have a notification class. It's currently there in desktop, but it'll be soon on Android too. We're using FCM for notifications on Android, and we have system tray for notifications on desktop. And there's a screenshot there which says this deserves a screenshot because it was the first time my code for screenshot ran. So my mentor said that, let's take a screenshot. And then we have an authentication class, but unfortunately Rocketchat doesn't provide an API for having federated login. So we can't have OAuth in Ruqola as of now. Then we have the user interface. So currently, this is the login screen. We haven't yet worked on the user interface, so please be kind. This is the login interface. If you type in the server as demo.rocket.chat, your username and password, you'll sign in. You can see the rooms on the left, the username, and the logout button. Then this is the room. I know it looks like a bit like IRC right now, but we'll start to working on UI soon. And not just Rocketchat, you can use it for any other site too. Like if you fill in the server as chat.wikitolearn.org, you'll sign into rooms from your Wikitolearn chat. And there you have those messages. So it's really an abstracted project, and you can use it for your own purpose. And for the UI, we're planning to use Kirigami. As Marco told, all the features, there are a lot of features. As you can see in the screenshot, the buttons, they're really small on Android currently, so you can't really see anything or use anything. So for a cross-platform consistent code, we'll use Kirigami. Then future plans. Of course, the UI needs a lot of work. It looks kind of spaghetti for now. So UI, and we want to have support for iOS too. It does run on iOS, but there's some platform-specific features like notifications, which require different codes. So we'll need to work on that. And then we'll soon release Ruqola 1.0, probably in September or August. So that's about Ruqola. And then there's this quick mock-up. I don't know, it doesn't run. Okay. So we log in, but if you type the wrong password, it'll just log out itself. And if you type the right password, it logs in, loads, and shows you the rooms. Then you can chat. So the backend is done for now, and we now need to work on the UI. Okay, that's it. So if you want to work or contribute to Ruqola, these are the Git repos, and you just have to open Qt Creator, go to the Ruqola directory, open the dot profile, and you'll see something like this project structure. I've told you about most of the classes here, authentication, message client, message Ruqola class. So that's it. And you create an account on demo.rocket.chat, and you set to rock and roll. And then there's this last thing that I need your feedback. Like, it's currently my, it was built from scratch, like this December. And it's been just 6 months. So knowledge only grows if shared. That's our wiki to learn motto. So we do need feedbacks. Tell us what do you think of Ruqola or your plans on how to use it. I already know two students who plan to use Ruqola for their own projects. So if you have anything in mind, come talk to me. That's it, finally. Any questions or suggestions or feedbacks? Anything for the UI? I know it looks shit right now.
So have you guys thought about creating a telepathy plugin for that?
Yes.
And?
Like Ruqola, you can use it for your own server. If you have a server, put in the server your username and password, and it will provide you a basic chat application, like which can work on desktop, Android, and probably iOS soon. So that's what Ruqola does.
Okay, so I have a question.
Yeah.
I'm not exactly familiar with Rocketchat, but I assume that it's open source.
Yeah, it is.
Have you thought about contributing the federated login APIs as a feature back upstream into Rocketchat?
Not yet.
Okay, because I just thought that this would be a brilliant
opportunity. Yeah, that can be done, but they won't allow just anyone to build an API for them.
Exactly. Well, you've made it into KDE.
Yeah.
It's not a big jump to contribute new APIs upstream into Rocketchat, and this would be a pretty good feature because federated login is something that
yes, we do need it.
We'd like if we want to integrate with KDE's identity system, and yeah,
okay.
Cool. Any other questions? Yeah.
This is a Google Summer of Code project, correct?
Yes.
How has your experience been?
Well, we've completed the backend, we've yet to work on the UI, and we're taking help from the Kirigami people. I mean, Alex and Marco, they're really, really helpful. They even designed the logo, so I think it's going pretty good for now.
I'm Valerie, I'm one of the
admins. I know, I read your mails daily.
Hi!
I get your status report updates.
If I may, it's the question. It's not just about technical. If you're stressed out or if you feel like
go for it.
It's not. I mean, if there's any communication gaps between the mentors and the because mentoring is something that we take very seriously.
No,
we have our own mentor program.
Very amazing. He's super, super, super amazing. I just love him, Ricardo Icanali and Gabriel.
Yeah.
So he's like very helpful. I haven't seen that humble guy anywhere.
Awesome. So I suppose that we're doing mentoring pretty well then.
Sad he couldn't come, but he
awesome.
Had an exam tomorrow.
Repository.
I don't understand.
Could you show the address of the repository again?
Okay, sure.